Green able to secure the turnover and get the ball to that man, Kevin Durant, who has 46. And talk about some passion and emotion. James Harden displaying it there, understanding what's at stake here.
Durant, 11 to 13 at the line, and a three-point Brooklyn lead.
Marv, the Bucks only have one timeout, so they may try to get it in quickly and get that report for a quick two or three opportunity.
Four-point game. Here comes Giannis, and he's fouled by Harden, and that is a good foul.
Definitely a great foul. Giannis had a head of steam. He's going to easily get to the rim and convert. Harden, great awareness there, fouling Giannis, making him earn it at the free throw line.
Earlier, we had asked Steve Nash, in light of this, James looking for more support in the crowd, and the decibel level is about the highest I've ever seen here in Brooklyn. But we asked Steve if he would go to half of Giannis, and he said, he's not above doing that. He said, I go pretty low. But Giannis hits the first. And he has done as well as Mike Budenholzer would hope for at the line here this evening. He's 4 for 6 thus far. 12.5 remaining. This is the second rebounded by Durant, who's tied up and fouled by both Antetokounmpo and Middleton, and Durant upset. He was virtually put into a headlock. So that means Durant to go to the line to carry with 11.5 seconds remaining.
Fittingly right there, that rebound ended up in the hands of Kevin Durant, who gets a chance to shoot two free throws for 50 points. But right now, a lot of pushing and shoving inside. It looked like Griffin and Tucker got banged up, and Durant a little frustrated that Antetokounmpo was grabbing a little too strong, but 50-point possibility here for Durant. Incredible, Marv.
12 for 14 at the line. The Nets lead by 3. seconds remaining.
Well, if he makes this next free throw, it's a two-possession game for Milwaukee. Durant wants that shot back, for sure. This is a big free throw right now by Kevin Durant.
One or two at the line, and the Bucks will take their final timeout. Durant, one shy of his playoff career high of 50 points. So the Nets do have a timeout for me.
One of the great scorers in the history of the NBA, Kevin Durant, took over here in this second half, facilitating, getting his 10 assists, making plays, doing it all over the floor now. Tough shot after tough shot after tough shot. Not taking a break at all. 48 minutes. The only thing he did, the only mistake, was missing that free throw. But other than that, a textbook, legendary, iconic performance with this team that back against the wall. So much at stake. Kevin Durant, incredible.
All right, if you're the Bucks, what do you do?
Well, first of all, you got to get a quick hitter out of this timeout. Try to score right away. Set up your defense. And on that first pass in, try to get a hard track, maybe get a steal off that trap. If not, you're going to have to foul with the Brooklyn Nets right away.
11.5 seconds remaining. Bucks will put it in play in their front court. They are down by 4.
And right now, after that timeout, the Bucks are out of timeouts. So executing getting a quick steal, a must for the Bucks. And of course for Brooklyn, inbound the ball and get it to Kevin Durant or one of your good free throw shooters.
All right, here's Middleton with a catch and shoot three, rebound Shabbat. And that will do it as Shabbat was fouled with 6.5 remaining. So Landry Shabbat will go to the line as Giannis Antetokounmpo has fouled out. He points with 34 points, 12 rebounds, 4 assists.
And as you said earlier, Marv, Giannis gave it his all. I mean, just an incredible performance, his effort, 42 minutes, left it all on the floor, but just not enough against Kevin Durant and these Nets.
Shabbat, a good foul shooter, 86% during the regular season.
And I'm stunned right now, Marv. I mean, Milwaukee was in control, and then Kevin Durant took over with a legendary playoff performance. Just incredible.
So the Nets bounce back from the second half loss. And the Nets now lead this Boston Celtics 2-2 in 6 back in Milwaukee Thursday night. Brooklyn trailed by as many as 17 points with just under 7 minutes remaining in the third quarter, and they outscored the Bucks by 23 after that.
I mean, it's incredible. I keep saying that, but it is. The thing you worry about, though, going back to game 6, can the Bucks team mentally and emotionally recover after being up so big and losing in this fashion?
All right, let's check in the